Drones are good. Drones are great. Drones are fantastic, but they have one huge problem. Humans. Humans that crash their drones so goddamn always, especially on YouTube. If only there was a way around that, a way to get all the good, great, and fantastic aspects without having to worry about humans getting in the way. Well, there is. And all you need is a Skydio R1, an Apple Watch, and a dream. I'm Rene Ritchie. Welcome back to Vector. Thank you so much for joining me again. Let's hit this. The Skydio R1, which the company refers to as a self-driving camera, isn't new. It's been available since February. What's new is the Apple Watch app that lets you guide it from your wrist. I said guide rather than control because the whole point of the Skydio R1 is to let the AI, the artificial intelligence, do the flying. You don't tell it to go up or down, left or right, to pitch or yaw. You just tell it to lead, follow, orbit, boomerang, and the like, and the AI figures out the details. To do that, it has 13 cameras to pull in the world around it, an NVIDIA Jetson 256-core AI processor to crunch all the data, and a custom autonomy engine to turn that computer vision into actionable machine flying. The result is something that still requires an iPhone or an Android phone to take off and to land, but otherwise really can function with what I said up front, an Apple Watch and a dream. To test it out, once I finished unboxing it, I grabbed some friends, hit the road, and then promptly went off-road. Takeoff was super simple. You literally connect and swipe up from the iPhone.
Blinking. Yeah!
From there, you pick a target, whether it's a human or a vehicle, and then you can pick from a wide range of different shots on the Apple Watch. And yeah, I'm totally gonna sound like a hyperbolic noob who thinks self-driving cameras were invented yesterday, but it's hella cool. I can barely drive a car, so the life expectancy of any SDC that I happen to pilot myself would be around roughly 30 seconds, and then I'd be actively trying to nice dat it out of a tree or off a roof or picking up its atoms scattered across the galaxy. There's a good amount of regular and dramatic shots to choose from, and thanks to a robust SDK from Skydio, developers can add more tricks to its bag over time as well. Now, the future, as always, isn't cheap. The Skydio R1 is $2,000. That's more than an iPhone XS Max, less than a MacBook Pro. So you have to determine whether the autonomy, whether the ability for it to get you the footage you need without you crashing those $2,000 into a tree makes it worth it. I did lose connection a few times, at which point the R1 patiently hovered nearby and waited for me to reconnect. And I did have trouble letting go and trusting the machine not to self-crash, especially as it got near the trees. And yeah, even when everything went perfectly, the laws of physics dictated only about a 15 minutes of useful 4K time in the sky between charges. But wow, that 4K time in the sky. You can live stream at 720p, but you really want to connect up to USB-C and pull that 4K footage as soon as you're done. It's amazing. Landing is just as easy as taking off. Swipe down on your iPhone. There is a software joystick so you can micromanage and manually steer if you really want to get it over a safe zone, for example. But really, swipe, land, done. If you're a pilot and you want to pilot, I totally get you wanting a giant control rig so you can get your piloting on. If you don't want anything to do with that great power and the responsibility that comes with it, but you still want the terrific shots that come from it, then this is totally that. Unbelievable footage, tiny, unobtrusive watch app to guide it with. And if I got dropped into anything from an off-road adventure to a full-on Jurassic Park experience, this is the camera I'd want with me. Not for the movies, for the much better book. If you've only seen the movie and never read the book, you're missing out. Do yourself a favor and head on over to audible.com/vector or text vector to 500-500 and get Jurassic Park or any book from their huge catalog for free right now. If you love listening to videos or podcasts, you'll love listening to books. Start your 30-day trial and, again, get your first audiobook for free at audible.com/vector or via text by sending vector to 500-500. Thank you so much, Audible, and thank you for checking them out and supporting the show. So that's it, the Skydio R1, an autonomous drone that you don't quite control, but you sort of tell what you want with your Apple Watch. And yeah, it feels like living in the future. It's the stuff that I've been dreaming about since I was a kid, and it's starting to come. And I hope we see a lot more of it, and soon. But now I want to ask you, do you have a drone yet? If not, is this the sort of drone you're interested in? If so, is this the kind of drone you might look at next? Hit like, hit subscribe, and then hit the comments below and let me know. Thank you so much for watching.